Hello everyone, Creative Venus here, and today we will learn how to design this beautiful 3D bar chart. And this looks really beautiful because we have used gradient finish in it. So please subscribe to our channel and join the membership. So let's begin with the tutorial. First we have to format the background, and here we have to fill the gradient color. So you have to click on the gradient, and on the first node or the gradient stop you can fill dark blue, and on the second gradient stop you can fill the purple color. Change the gradient type to radial, and you can select one of the corner direction for the radial. Now insert this rectangle. Slightly increase its width and height. So 13 by 3 looks fine to me. Remove the outline, go to 3D rotation, and then change the orientation like this, and you will get an isometric shape. Now we have to play with the gradient color here, and here you have to be very innovative, and you can design different gradient styles here. I would suggest you to study about complementary colors, then it would be very easy for you to fill the gradient colors. So here we have used the combination of yellow colors as a gradient in this first rectangle. Then duplicate this rectangle, and what you have to do is decrease the height number or height value, and width will remain the same, and place it towards the top and remove its fill, and we will only keep its outline. Change the outline color to white, increase its width, and increase the depth effect, and you can keep it like 5 points, and you can manually adjust it to make sure there is no extra space, and not duplicate it. Remove the outline and fill gradient finish in it. Go to the effects option here, and then increase the depth. So it depends upon the value you want to showcase in your bar chart, so you have to keep the depth according to that. So we have kept it like 100 points for the moment. And you can slightly increase the transparency here. So by increasing the transparency, it will look more beautiful, and it will have that glass effect. And you can change the material to metallic. Now select all these and press Ctrl plus G to group all these three items, and then you can easily move the grouped items. Now insert the text box, and we will add some text elements on this first, the first component of our bar chart. So this is the value we want to showcase here. And then go to the text effects and change the 3D orientation. And you can place the text at the center, or you can place it on the side of this cuboid as well, or the bar chart. It is totally up to you. Now go to insert Now let's add some icon here, and we will use the default icon repository of Office 365, and we have picked one of the random icon here. Change its orientation and then change the color as well, and let's place it here. I think we can place one copy at the front as well, but we will do it later. First insert a text box here, and then we have to write the name of this bar. So this is the step A, or it can be anything. It depends upon the data you have. It can be like a month or a date range or a product name, anything. So we have written step A. Let's write step only, and we will write A in a bigger font to make it look more stylish. Change the font color to black, because white will have visibility issues. Make sure the text is dark. You can use dark blue as well. Now increase the font size of A, change the orientation, and place it here. Make sure it is at the center. You can adjust it manually. Slightly reduce the font size because that was too much. So how about this beautiful bar chart? I think it has come out really nice. If you really like it, please hit the like button, and if you haven't subscribed and you're watching this video, it would be really great if you can subscribe. So now we have placed this icon in the front as well. Now let's duplicate this complete shape, and then we have to change the colors and the bar height as per the value. We have to pick a color scheme here. I think we should move towards the blue. Let's pick this one. And for the second gradient stop, let's pick this bright blue color. And similarly, fill the gradient finish on this bar as well. Now we have to increase the transparency, so you can keep it at 30% for both the gradient stops. And now we have to change the icons, the value, and the height of this bar. So let's pick a different icon here. So you can find plenty of icons here for every topic, and I think Microsoft has done a great job by adding this icons repository. This really saves time. Now duplicate this icon and let's change its orientation towards the front and place it at the center of this shape. And next we have to adjust the height, because this is an increasing bar chart. So the first was 100, and let's make it 150. And now you have to adjust it manually. Move it, either move it with the mouse, with the help of the mouse, or you can use the arrow keys or a keyboard. And now we have to change the values. First place it at the center, and we are using some random values here, and change the step to step B. So our second bar is also ready. Let's group all these items. If you find it difficult to select any shape, you can always go to selection pane. So the second bar is also ready, and similarly you can design the third bar. Change to step C, and now we have to change the icons, the numbers and the height of this bar. Let's first change the colors, and this time we will follow the green. One will be the light color and one green stop will be a dark color. And similarly at the bottom we will fill the gradient finish, and now change the icon. So let's pick this alien icon here. So that was easy, and change the value at the top. Now we have to change the depth of this bar. Once the value is changed, you can use your arrow keys on a keyboard or the mouse to place it on the base and then move the text to the center. Now shift the entire shape and send to back. Make sure all these three items are equidistant from each other. Now duplicate the slide, and on the second slide we will draw a few lines and fill gradient color. Change the gradient type to path and fill white color on one of the gradient stop, and on the second gradient stop fill bright blue color. Now increase the transparency of one of the gradient stops. We want the transparency at the edges, and for that we have to increase the transparency of the white color like this. Now duplicate this line multiple times. Now select all the lines, align center, increase the width. Now group all these together by pressing Ctrl plus G. Change the orientation like this. Increase the height. Duplicate and place it here behind the bar chart. And send to back. And you can do lots of items here. You can create many beautiful components surrounding the bar charts, like some tablet, some PC or some server data related items. You can try lots of things here. So now you can finally adjust the background as well if you want. So this is the final output. I hope you will like it. So please subscribe to our channel, join the membership, and do not forget to download it from the G Drive link provided in the video description. So please subscribe to our channel, and we will see you guys in our next video. Till then, bye bye and enjoy.